Testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing.
Oh, a little better. Ladies and gentlemen, James here. Hope that this video don't cut off on me. I don't know how much, got enough battery life, but you never know with the microchip. You only got 70 minutes on it. But, I want to dedicate this video to a church up in Youngstown, Ohio, called Mount Calvary, Pentecostal Church. I want to dedicate them. I want to say thank you, because I've been on this journey. My name is James. Last name Thomas. I used to live in Youngstown, Ohio, back in the 90s. I grew up there, practically grew up there. And back in the mid-90s, I had a couple friends, we went and visited Mount Calvary Church. And at the time, Bishop Wagner was there. And so, at the time, we, as church as usual, having a session, and it was a good sermon. I forgot what the sermon was about. But I remember at the end of the sermon, there was one of the people who wanted to give their life to Christ. And I think it was me and probably one other person probably gave their life to Christ back then. It was a warm summer day. And that's when I experienced the Father, through the Son, through the Holy Spirit, and it helped me receive the Spirit of the Father's Spirit, which is the Holy Spirit. And it was good, and I just wanted to say thank you. It wasn't an easy journey, and at some point, I did kind of, you know, I had it for a while, but like some people who come to first, who don't stick to the regimen of fasting, prayer, reading scriptures, and doing things like that to keep a relationship with the Father, you fell into the traps and the temptations of this world. That's what happened to me. And from that point in time and up until 2007, you know, the Father reconnected with me through a couple people down here in Columbus, Ohio. In fact, he brought up someone who mentored me. The dude, the Bill, through Jesus Christ, ministry in the streets, ministry in the nurses' homes. I've seen the ministry of homeless people. I've seen the casting out of bad generation curses of spirits. I've seen things like that. And also the person who was mentoring me and training me in the name of Jesus Christ was a woman named Pauline. Her last name is Newton. And she's from Columbus, Ohio, and she gave me good reference because she said that your particular church during this, back in the 70s and 80s, I think she said in the 70s and 80s, helped her when she needed prayer during her young Christian life. And Mount Calvary, you was one of the blessings. And then there was another man down here named Tommy Stewart. He told me about how blessing Bishop Wagner was to him and what he meant so much. He gave a great reverence to the late Bishop Wagner. He said that how he influenced and how the testimonies of his life and had made him. But I just want, you know, but there was people down here that I met over time that had never been to Youngstown, but when they called up there back at that time, when you had people that were prayer lines, you helped out a lot of people, and the church did wonderful things, and some people got the chance to grow in the Spirit. And two people that give testimony. I have a relative that been at your church for a while, my cousin and I gave my life to Christ. And I want to let you know that it's been a journey, because like I mentioned before, you know how sometimes, you know, just some people, they don't stay disciplined on the path of righteousness as far as having a prayer life, giving up the old things, and allowing the enemy to slip in those things that kind of lead you off the path. And like some people that felt like it was convicted, I feel like I was afraid they would come, because I knew it felt like it's like some people feel like they betray God, and we don't have the understanding of how God can be merciful when sometimes we don't understand the effect. And even though if we mess up like a David or a Paul, a King David or Paul, that we forget the love of Christ, that he just wants to come back and repent and come back and start over. And there was a point in my life that death was about to take me, and I had to get to somebody. I had to get into a church, and I was led me to this woman who kind of mothered me and took me in like a mother hen. And she called him, and she kind of guided me in by the word of God. And by the word of God, I start seeing the miracles, signs, and wonders that God showed me. But I'm still on the path. But I just want to, you know, a lot of people don't take time out to really thank people, you know, once they leave. You know, it was like that one scripture, and you're probably familiar with the one scripture where the three were three blind men, and there's only one came back and thanked Jesus and said, thank you. The other one said, and he said, where are the other men at, you know? You know, because he set their eyes, you know, he unblinded them. But I know it took me this long, and I'm sorry to get a chance to say goodbye and say thank you to before the bishop passed away. But I just want to say thank you to the church that allowed me to accept me. Because there was not too many people at that time, and even till this day, that even though I wasn't really a member for a certain amount of time, by you being obedient to God and allowing me to get receive the Spirit, you know, God has got me back on the path. And I pray that the members in the church will still be blessed. And I don't know about Mr. Bishop Wagner and his family, how they're doing, but I hope they're still being blessed in the Lord. But I just hope that this video will get to somebody, and that they will see this video. And this was back in the early 90s. I know it's, you know, it's been a while, and you're probably not familiar with my face. But I just want to say thank you. Because my growth, I think about my growth and my maturity in Christ Jesus. But it had to be somebody. And I hope that there'll be churches like you that will keep that all souls come in, don't matter what congregation, don't matter if they're non-believer, if they come one time, or if they come back, if they come two times. But the important thing about it is your church understands souls. And you have a lot of churches that don't understand that. You got some people that got their own special program before they get saved. And this is what I liked about Bishop Wagner. He wasn't like that. There were souls need to be saved. They weren't giving life to Christ except Jesus. He was open for it. So they could be sealed with the Father's Spirit. So, and just like any other church, I see the persecution that they put your church up under, like many churches who do the will of the Father. You have people because of the blessings that certain blessings that the church was given, and people got jealous. You got people that, I understand how some people get jealous, and some people even speak of that. But throughout all of that, you know, what's the amazing part about it was, testimonies about Bishop, the late Bishop Lambert's life. And I never know if people would tell me, because I wasn't really understanding, because I was only there at one time, but I didn't understand the magnitude of God's walk with this man and the signs and wonders that God put around him. And so I just want to say thank you. Sometimes some people need to come back and say thank you. But since then, it's been a journey. And God got me back on track. And sometimes you should go back to the ones that never forget you, the people that reached out. But the ones who you grab a soul. If the church will understand that, these church will understand when you grab a soul, you never know. You're saving someone from eternal damnation. And a lot of churches don't understand that. I'm not confident. I hope you still understand that your church is one of the blessings. That because when I was up there in the 90s and the 80s, and I grew up around the Youngstown region, I was at a church, but it did teach me relationship with Jesus. I know about the church, but I didn't know about relationship. And I went to a Catholic church. And the one well known, you know, is St. Columba. They know much about God, but they never taught me about Jesus. They never taught me about the Father and His Spirit, His Holy Spirit. But your church did. I got the hope. I received that from the Father. I received the Father giving His part of Him, His gift to me. A lot of people get stuck into the mindset of religion and denomination. It's not about denomination. Religion. It's about the souls. So I pray once in a while that if your prayers go out to where you at, that the strongholds can be pulled down around where you at on the south side. Because you know how enemy you were aware, some of you mature aware how Satan takes territory. That's why you see how